We are pleased, as always, to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Denver Broncos and the Los Angeles Rams. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and CD, our matchup here in this one, as so many do, revolves around the quarterback position. We've got an interesting pairing here.
And both of them have terrific ability to improvise, and that means when the first read's not there, how quickly can you go through your progressions? Can you hang in there and take a shot as you release it? Can you buy time outside of the pocket? Can you pull it down and run if need be? I think we'll see all of those traits on display in this one.
And we are underway from SoFi Stadium. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. So here are the Broncos now for their opening drive. They're led onto the field by their quarterback, a man who's made quite the name for himself in the NFL, and that's Russell Wilson.
And similar to his nickname, Russell Wilson has a dangerous mix of skills, the ability to throw from the pocket and extend plays and throw on the run. Not to mention an absolute winner. Usually has his team in the playoffs competing for Super Bowl opportunities.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Now a first carry for the former Tar Heel, Javonte Williams.
And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
Now Williams.
And not much. Maybe a yard up to the 29.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
On second and 9, Wilson. And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Leonard Floyd, the old Georgia Bulldog, finding his way into the backfield.
Anytime you sack Russell Wilson, that's a win for the defense. But to get him here on his opening drive of the ball game, that's a really big win for that defense.
And the goal every week, keep him in the pocket. Don't let him get to the perimeter, because when he's in the open field, not only can he hurt you, but also you lose sight of receivers downfield, and they'll hurt you with big plays.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
This one swung out to Williams.
And he's going to get this to the 31, but that is still well short of what he needed. It's a gain of 6, but not enough, as he'll be forced to punt on their first drive of the game.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
fourth down, Sam Martin is on to punt for the Broncos. Cooper Kupp deep for L.A.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken just outside the 20-yard line. So now the Rams will get their first opportunity with a football. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. First down at Stafford. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown.
Well, partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using five defensive backs, six defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
On here, Brandon McManus for the point after. And he's got it. 7-0 Broncos. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Matthew Stafford and the rest of the Rams offense set to take over once more. And looking to erase his memory bank from his opening drive a moment ago that ended in a pick six for the first points of the ball game.
And in my experience, a lot of quarterbacks, after throwing a pick six, the first thing they want to do is fire another one and get those points back immediately. But what really helps you get back in sync is a good, long, methodical drive, mixing the run and the pass, tamp things down a little bit.
Stafford here, coming off his pick six. Got a man open, it's Tyler Higbee. And he'll get this one way up, just shy of the 45-yard line. Well, maybe that'll help him settle back into a groove after the interception on the first drive here, picking up the first to start drive number two.
And it is just starting over, isn't it? Sometimes it's just how you have to do it. You have to erase things from your mind. Don't worry about what happened before, because over the course of the game, the good players, things turned out pretty well for them, and that's what he's trying to do here.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Now Stafford. He'll get this into the hands of Van Jefferson. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds.
That was a really nice job there, stretching zone coverage by running that route deep enough before breaking it back towards the sideline and being open.
And a precise throw for the reception in the first. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Here's the first carry of the game for Cam Akers. And they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
When a draw works, it can be a thing of beauty. But when it doesn't, oh, it can be ugly. And in this case, loss of yardage ugly.
Second and 11 now. Now Stafford. Now that'll be caught by Cobb. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating? The guys who just gave up that play.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Stafford now to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
You definitely would like to have hit on that one, because now you've got a third and long showing up, and you just know defense is going to be getting after it. They are pinning their ears back, and they are coming.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now it's Stafford. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
And that's exactly what defenses talk about. You've got to find ways to get off the field when you can, especially on third down. And third down defense going to be vital in this game. Able to knock that one away and force a fourth down.
Here comes the Rams punter now. KJ Hamler deep for the Broncos. And the fair catch is taken at about the 13-yard line here. They'll call that a 33-yard punt with no return. And it'll be first and 10 Broncos from deep in their own territory. So now the second drive offensively coming up for the Denver Broncos. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
They go play action now. Wilson on the move to his left. He'll get five out of the scramble. It's second down.
Oh, yes, that was good pressure applied that time by the defensive unit. They forced him out wide to his left, but with nobody home, he decided to tuck it and go, and he's able to turn it into a short gain.
On second down, Williams. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher, third and six.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Third down, Wilson. This one complete to Jerry Jeudy. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's one of those where it feels like backyard football in a sense. You say, forget about the route. Just run to the open spot in the middle of the field, and I'll find you. Good throw, good concentration on the catch, and they pick up the first down.
Now a first down carry, it's Williams. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The last run got six, now second and four. From the shotgun, Wilson. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
Now they face a third down and four after that incompletion on second down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. He's got his 6'5 receiver, that's Tim Patrick.
Let's go, baby.
Has a pretty good throw on the curl route there. Third down, and they pick up a first.
Defense should be aware for that, right?
They should be aware, but it was so hard sometimes.
Yeah, it's not easy.
Because when they sell that route really well, you think they're going upfield, then they curl back, show their numbers to the quarterback, and complete the play.
A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. To throw is Wilson. That one's complete to Tomlinson. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
Let's just make this one simple. Could he be any more open than he was on that play?
Yeah, they lost him going to the outside.
Hard to believe because you go through your accounting on each and every defensive snap. Who's got who? What defense you're in? That was totally a blown coverage.
To throw again is Wilson. That's caught left side by Judy. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams 40. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Broncos football as we begin quarter number two. As they've got it with a first and 10. Throwing is Wilson. They're looking for Judy, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And the Rams will take over possession here up at the 44.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
The offense for Los Angeles returns to the field, and the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. So that's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their own 44. After the interception, here's Stafford. Gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
And Brandon, as you know, sometimes it's a lot tougher to run with these tight ends nowadays in the NFL. They're just bigger wide receivers. He lined up on the left side of formation, ran a drag route across the field, and tried to work his way open. He was able to make the catch, but the defenders were there. Couldn't do a whole lot with it afterwards.
Here's a run with Akers on second down. Akers hit. He coughs it up. It's picked up by the Broncos. There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B. One starts with an S. Ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you've got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
Come on now. Let's do this.
They begin the drive with Williams. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes,
and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. They go backwards there 2 yards, and second and one is now third and three.
Well, I would have figured after the 9 yard run on the previous play, getting one more yard wouldn't have been much of a problem. But apparently it was, and now it's third down.
The Broncos on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. Here it's third and three. They go play action with Wilson. And that's complete. Albert Okulebuna. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
Normally on third down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the first down and then some.
On first down, Wilson. He'll find Sutton on the right side, complete. And he will reach the 5 yard line before going out of bounds.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing, but as long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try and run. This is Williams. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Now it's Wilson. Touchdown! Tim Patrick from 3 yards out. And the Broncos will add on to their lead.
The defense is doing their best, but they're struggling right now. They'll look for some help from their own offense to keep them in the game.
McManus now for the extra point. And it's good to make it 14-0. That time a 6-play drive. And it ends with a Denver touchdown. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Cam Akers in the Rams offense ready to go back to work. And for him, it's been pretty limited involvement. Down on the scoreboard, maybe time to turn to this guy.
And you know me well. Winning games to me means starting with the running game and continuing to press the running game. Maybe you go away from him a little bit now, but the bottom line is he hasn't touched it enough to make a difference.
Well, they haven't established that running game yet. The question is, will they? So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. A shotgun snap for Stafford. This one to the left to Higbee. That catch good for only a couple.
Yeah, that one was covered pretty well because they were trying to leak the tight end out into the flat. I think they were hoping he could catch and turn upfield and pick up the first down.
Second and 8.
Let's go, D. 58, boys, 58, 58.
Throwing a Stafford. Looking sideline, incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a third and eight. Here's Stafford. And that is incomplete. But the pressure there on third down, forcing the errant pass. Fourth down coming up.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Here comes the Rams punter now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Yards on the punt, two on the return, and the Broncos take over, first down and 10. Russell Wilson now gears up to lead the offense again. He's got the lead here in the second quarter. He's thrown the touchdown, but also an interception. As a quarterback, does that interception, even though you're playing well, your team's got the lead, does that always stick in the back of your mind a little bit?
For the best ones, it just upsets them that they did that, because they don't think there should be any blemishes on their record. They think that they're way better than that. So your confidence gets tested a little bit. Being able to go back out there, maybe throw another touchdown, that'll tamp that down in a big way.
Yeah, because he's looked pretty good to this point. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Tackle made there by Traven Howard.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Wilson. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Snags it for the pick, and the Rams are going to take over at their own 11-yard line. Well, you know, this offense has had their way for the most part here in this first half, but that time, maybe they got a little greedy.
Well, it is hard to blame them, isn't it? Because like they said back in the 1980s, greed can be good. Stick with what's been working. But that time, I think you got a little bit too much air under that one, and it turned into a turnover that was much needed by that defense.
Getting set to go again, Matthew Stafford trots back onto the field. He's got to dig deep here, doesn't he? Team's losing. He's not playing well either.
And they always tell you, don't press. You'll make things a little bit worse. But in this particular situation, you try and heighten your play a little bit. So far, he's thrown one interception. He wants to balance that off with at least one touchdown pass in order to get his team back moving forward.
They'll fake it. Now Stafford. And he's got this to Jefferson. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they're having panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Stafford. Open man, Higbee, the tight end. 7 yards, the pickup there. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Working with a second and 3. Now a toss running left, Akers. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, and now they go from second and 2 to a tough 3rd and 4. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. They reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coach's two-minute drill.
That's onto the flat for Akers. And he's going to have a Rams first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Yeah, these are the types of plays they're going to need to hit on if they're going to get back into this game. It hasn't been the greatest of first halves, but this is a nice throw here on third down, and they keep the drive going.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. Out of the gun, Stafford. That's complete to his tight end, Higby. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his fifth catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Stafford. And that is incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To the air again, Stafford. And the Broncos get there and take him down. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. So now Stafford and the Rams, after the sack, they're staring up at a third and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Open man right side is cut, complete. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
Brandon, a good idea there on third down. Run a little clear out and hope you can get your receiver the ball coming across the formation. Nice design, but well played defensively, and they stop him well short.
Here comes the Rams punter now, as he'll come on to kick this one away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return. And control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And with a two-score lead already, they may just look to get this thing to the locker room. And they're just going to run it here up the middle. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. On the stop was Aaron Donald. So we come upon halftime with the visiting Broncos taking the lead to the locker room. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. First order of business, though. Let's get a look at the next-gen stats in that first half for Denver. And there were a few factors as to why they built this good-size advantage, but the rushing numbers were not all that amazing. We'll see if they can pick it up in the second half. Meanwhile, for the Rams, there's a look at what they were able to do throwing the football. And they'll need to get things in gear as they trail here at the break.
All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Rams set to receive the second half kickoff, and they trail here as we resume play. Taking it about the one. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Rams offense ready to begin quarter number three. And right out of the gate, they face what you'd think could be a pretty important drive.
I would say so. You know, they're down two scores. That's not the end of the world. It wasn't the strongest of first halves, but for them to start clawing back, they've got to start putting a little pressure on that defense, start cutting into this deficit. You can't have three and outs and expect to get that done.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. To throw is Stafford. And the hook up here to Allen Robinson. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Now it's Stafford. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Another attempt, another incompletion, and when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
Some tough running, but it only gets him to the 45. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now Stafford. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. From the gun, here's Stafford. Open man is Higbee, the tight end. A gain of 6 there on first.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage. Second down at 4. Back to throw, Stafford. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a holding penalty, and that'll send him backwards.
You know they're trying not to do that. I mean, we know that, right? We talk to them all the time. But sometimes the defensive guys just put you in awkward situations, and you get caught grabbing their jerseys.
Off the fake to Akers. Here's Stafford. And it's incomplete.
We've got to give out a little applause on that play. It has to go to the defense. More good work by them. They've taken away the passing lanes all game long, and you can see the frustration that it's causing because he just about threw that one into the first row.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and 1. They'll try and run for this with Akers. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
until the second half, but finally a red zone opportunity here. They have a first and 10 at the 18. Stafford. And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Van Jefferson there to make the grab. And the Rams have got this back to a one-score game. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard, you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. So an eight-play drive covering 80 yards. And it winds up with a touchdown for Los Angeles. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. Taken at the goal line. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
So now a look at the Broncos as they head back out there for their first possession of the second half. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change. Because otherwise, that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He completes this to Sutton. He finds some open field here. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. It's a big play there for the Broncos.
This is what made the West Coast offense a staple around the NFL in the 80s and 90s. You don't have to push the ball deep downfield to come up with big plays. And there's an example of that right there.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Here's Wilson. Open man, and again it's Sutton. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game, and you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9. The shotgun, Wilson, flushed out right. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
Nice job there defensively. A great time to dial up a blitz.
And give him credit under center instead of throwing it away. Actually, a pretty good job of getting past the line of scrimmage, not losing yardage. To the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. This one swung out to Williams. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line.
the speed with which this offense can get down the field. It's taken them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up with a first and goal.
To throw is Wilson. This is caught. That's good for a gain of six, second and goal.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
They'll run it with Williams. And he's going to be shoved back short of the goal line. He tried to break that plane but couldn't get there, and that's going to leave him now at third and goal. They were stopped last time from the one. Now here's another try on third and goal. They'll try to run it in. It's Williams. And Williams is going to be stopped short of the yellow line. He did not get there. Only a yard there, so it brings up fourth and goal.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Field goal would make it a two-score game, but they're going to go aggressive. They're going to try this thing on fourth and goal. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. And he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. Andrew Beck taking it in from a yard out. And the Broncos are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a two-touchdown lead, right? Because you have taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
McManus's point after is good, and it's now 21-7. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Taking it about the one. And he will be taken down here on the return on what will wind up being the final play of this third quarter. So both teams trade touchdowns, and the third is worth through three quarters of play. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
I'm coming. 58 to Mike, 58.
looking to throw again on second down. Stafford to the right side and complete to Jefferson. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure they only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. A shotgun snap for Stafford. That'll be caught. It's Cobb. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A big play that time through the air. 31 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now Stafford gets this into the hands of the tight end, Higbee. A gain of 6 there on first. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Working with a second and 4. Again, it's Stafford. And that is incomplete.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
The Rams on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is 3rd and 4. Stafford. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now 4th down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Desperation time for Stafford on 4th down. Man open, it's Kupp, he's got it. Touchdown, Rams! Cooper Kupp, 27 yards. And the Rams have made it a one-score game again here in the 4th. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the 4th.
And that's what these guys have done all game long, because they've scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game. And by now, we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense, because they're going to need to find some way to get the ball back.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this 4th quarter. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. KJ Hamler returning it. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. Wilson's throw taken in by Sutton. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. Now it's Wilson. This will be caught. Judy. Past the 20. And all the way home for a Broncos score.
Yeah, good job.
Jerry Judy, 73 yards. And the Broncos use the big play to extend their fourth quarter lead. But for Jerry Judy, this is why he was a first-round pick back in 2020. The route running, the hands are great, but the speed, that sets him apart.
And I think this is what the early proponents of the forward pass were thinking about. Get it to a receiver and have him do some work afterwards in order to create the big play we just saw there.
Extra point from McManus is good. And the lead now up to 14. So the drive there, they went 80 yards in three plays. And it culminates in a touchdown by the Broncos. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Taken in at the three. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. And the LA offense ready for this next possession. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
On first down, Stafford here. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
No sense risking anything there on first down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing is Stafford. He'll check this down to Akers out of the backfield. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. Now we've got whistles, and the man slow to get up here is Jones. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
59, 32, 40 gut, 40 gut.
Now it's Stafford. And that's incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Second and 10. Stafford looks to throw again. Now that'll be caught by Kupp, and he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Well, correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. To throw is Stafford. He'll dump this off to Akers. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
To throw again on second down. Stafford, he'll get this one to Kupp, complete. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Stafford on first down. They'll set up the screen here to Akers. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. But despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Throwing again on second down. Stafford complete. Jefferson the target. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. Stafford now to throw. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Here we go on fourth. Stafford. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Broncos will take over on downs. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that
They're
one.
They're down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at the 40. They'll try and run down some clock with Williams. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Again, it's Williams. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now a man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Williams. The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. The win for the Broncos, seemingly assured. They go down to a knee. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world, and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop telling me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something, and they did in this one. So this one will wind up a Denver victory. And we talk so much about the turnover battle, determining who wins, who loses. This game, no exception. Air-free football, no turnovers at all, and they win it.
So this is one you don't have to convince your team that what you're saying is accurate. And you know what I'm talking about. Head coach always stands up in front of the team and says, guys, if we do this, this, and this, we'll win. And usually they say, if we win the turnover battle, we'll win. Well, here's the proof right there. Win the turnover battle. Go on to victory. Now the guys believe. You move on to the next lesson where you have to convince them. This one is now planted.